Hey Notion fans, Ben here from Notion Mastery. Today is a very good day because we finally have access to webhooks in Notion. If you have done any sort of automation with Zapier or Make before, you know that in order to observe changes in our Notion data, we have to constantly be polling for changes and then adding filters on top of that to be able to react to certain changes specifically in our automations, our external automations. And what webhooks do is it allows us to publish changes to our automations externally when specific actions happen and only when those actions happen. So we're not having to constantly pull for changes and we're getting changes in real time. So let's have a look and dive in here. This is my database for managing our student subscriptions. And you can see here, I have a Stripe subscription ID reference. And if I switch over to my my Zapier, the sales funnel here, this is where when new subscriptions are created, we automatically put them into this database and we associate them with the new Notion Mastery student record and things like that. So I got a bunch of automations already running that kind of we can manage our program. But right now I have this thing where when somebody requests to cancel their subscription, I have to click on this edit Stripe subscription and click cancel in the Stripe interface. But what this one allows us to do is do something reactively from our Notion data really simply when I make a change. For example, I change the status to cancel. What I want to have happen is to cancel the Stripe subscription on Stripe and then pull back to the post back to Notion and actually mark that as canceled when it's done, which I think I already have actually, so I don't need to do that step. So I just need to make a change when I've changed to cancel. And so we're gonna go over to our automations here. And my trigger is going to be when the status is marked as cancel. So anytime we move the status to cancel, we're going to do a new action. And that new action is gonna be this new guy, send webhook. Awesome. So what a webhook is it's the definition here is a little muddy because webhooks traditionally require some kind of like registration and authentication. So this is like a basically like a posting to a URL type thing. And I think Notion has named it webhook just to kind of like make it feel that it's close to what a traditional webhook is. So we're posting to some specific link online when this action is performed. We can also add custom headers here. We should note here, and I confirm this, that these key value pairs are not encrypted. So this is not an appropriate place for your API tokens unless you are willing to risk exposing that to anyone else, any members who might have access to this automation. So just be aware, not encrypted, not a great place for passwords and things like that, but you can use that to send additional information with your quest. The cool thing about this is we can pass all of the properties from the page that triggered this onto our and you can see here that some of them are unchecked because we're not able to technically pass on formulas and rollups yet. Some formulas seem to be able to. This one, for example, this is a button, and this is a checkbox. So I don't know that maybe the checkboxes, certain formulas seem to be grayed out right now, and I'm not sure why, but certain formulas can be sent like this one here. But all I really need to be able to cancel that Stripe subscription ID is the subscription ID. And what else might I need? I also am going to need the OK ID. The OK ID is actually a formula that is pulling through the user's ID of the page of their student account versus their membership account. So I'll need that as well to be able to mark this record as canceled when I'm done. And that's all I really need. I just need to cancel the Stripe subscription ID. In fact, I probably don't even need this one. We'll just do that. But next up, I need a URL to post to. So over in Zapier, I'm going to create a new Zap inside of my funnel folder here. And I don't need Copilot. And my trigger is going to be webhooks. And the trigger event is going to be catch a hook because we're catching something that is being sent from Notion. We're not going to pick off a child key. And we're going to test. And it says here that it's listening and says, to confirm your trigger is set up correctly, we'll find recent requests in your account. Great, so I'll copy the URL and then we're gonna go back to Notion and paste it in the URL field. So theoretically, when the status is set to cancel, we're going to post a record to this endpoint here and we're gonna pass along the Stripe student ID from the subscription ID from Stripe rather. So let me hit save. Cool. So now theoretically, should be able to mark this as canceled, and we'll mark a couple records as canceled. And obviously, we're not going to do this because we don't want to cancel our student subscriptions, but we'll be able to at least test the data and show that you can work with this data in the Zapier side of things after we've marked things as done. So theoretically, we should go back to Zapier here. And we're looking at the listening thing, and I can test the trigger by clicking test. Great, we got record A pulled through. Let's have a look at record A. And we can see the there's a data point, object on the data here that says the source is automation. Here's the automation ID and the action ID and the event ID and the attempt number. And I think Notion tries to send up to three attempts to your endpoint before it may mark it as failed. But you can tell which automation is firing it and which attempt it is. So this is our first attempt. And then in the data object here, you can see this is a page. This is the page's ID. Who was it created by? That's probably going to be me. Who was it last edited by? And so on and so forth. And down in our properties, we've got our Stripe subscription ID. And if you're familiar with, Notion properties, this gets pretty, they're, nested here. And we've got a sub ID right here under data properties, Stripe subscription ID, rich text, plain text. So that would be the property that we want to grab if we wanted to actually work with that ID on Stripe. So as a test record, I can continue with that selected record, and then I can do whatever I want with this. So I could send, I could send it back to Notion in some way if I wanted to. I could filter it out. I could add formatters. I could do other webhook posts. Like for example, I might want to make a request to the Stripe API with that subscription ID to cancel it. In fact, if I remember correctly, Zapier's Stripe integration does not allow you to look up a subscription directly. You have to do it with a customer. And so we would have to do this manually anyway. So let's have a look at that. Like if I were to do another post request configure, this is where I could click that slash for field mapping and I could find one of those Stripe API properties where I could get the, I could start typing subscription ID. And this is unfortunately tricky one where you can't really see it. Here we go. I clicked it perfectly. Rich text, text content. What else we got here? Link. I want the plain text version. Where's that one? Let's type plain text. There you go. Yes, this is the one I want. And so you can see here, now I can actually format a URL to the Stripe API in order to find that subscription, mark it as canceled. And then I might want to, for example, look up that record back in Notion and then mark that student as removed from the program or something like that. And if that were the case, I might want to go into my automation here and maybe I would select also the, I think OKID is the formula that actually pulls through the student's ID from the related student record that's related to this membership. So that way I have all the data I need in my external platform. And I don't have to sit here polling repeatedly to find if any of the subscriptions have been marked as canceled in the last 5 minutes. It's getting that information right away, right where I need to learn it, to be able to act on it, rather. So that's an early look at the automations thing. Really, with webhooks, really excited to see what people are going to build with this in the future. It really makes it such that we now have we can get data into Notion easily with the Notion API, and now we can get data out of Notion with the webhook system. And so it's really, really interesting opportunity for building these kind of really rich interactive dashboards where we're just interfacing with our data in Notion. I can make changes to my data. And now I can publish, make decisions about what's happening elsewhere outside the platform without too much manual oversight or expensive polling and things like that. So let me know in the comments what you're going to build with this, what you're excited to build with it, and we'll go from there. Hope that helps.